I mentioned translations, and that's something that I've been doing a great deal of lately. This is by Miguel Unamuno, the great critic and philosopher of 19th century, 20th century Spain, and it's called The Atheist Praise. I won't read the Spanish original, except for the last two lines, the first two lines, I'll read just so we can get the flavor of the Unamuno. It's called La Oración del Ateo, The Atheist Prayer. Oye mi ruego tú, Dios, que no existe, y en tu nada recoges a tu tierra. The Atheist Prayer. You who have never been God, hear me pray. Into your nothingness collect my cry. You who leave men but always leave them lies to comfort them. You who do not turn away our prayers but close the hopes our words convey. The farther off you flee, the more my wise old nursemaid speaks in memory and tries to sweeten my sad night as counsel may. How great you are! So great that you are no more than pure idea, my God. So great that cramped reality, though it may grow, cannot encompass you. You sealed my faith, God who does not exist, since I, like you, should then exist in truth, if you were true. I love doing translations because it teaches me to read the original in a new way. I never fail to find more in the original than I thought was there at first, because now I'm inside the poem, struggling with the syntax of it, and with the suggestions of it, and with those things that you take for granted when you're reading in only one language. When you're reading in transport, oh my, you discover so many things. Here's a translation from a wonderful poet who deserves to be better known. He's from Guatemala, 1884 to 1975. His name was Rafael Arellano Martinez, and this is called Los Hombres Lobos, The Man Wolf. The Man Wolf. First I said, brother, and put out my hand. Lamb after lamb then vanished from its stall. My soul unlearned the sound of brothers, and there, when I went to look, wolves, one and all. What ailed my soul that marched ahead so blind, my poor sad soul that dreamed and warmed to friends? How, as they loped, could I mistake their kind? How in their eyes miss their rapacious end? Then I, also a wolf, left straightway. Then I, a wolf, bedded in dirt, and then in each one found a brother. Till one day, there, when I went to look, they were all men. Los Hombres Lobos, Rafael Arellano Martinez. Before I read something from, maybe I should do it. This is from Juan Inés de la Cruz, who is one of the, maybe the first great poet of the Americas. Mexico, of course, 17th century, and this is, 17th and 18th century. And this is her sonnet. She was one of the great sonneteers of all time, and this is a sonnet in which she conveys how it wounds her to be insulted for her abilities. I have to say something about this theme, because it's one that runs through a great deal of her writing. She was brilliant. She was a child prodigy. She astounded everybody who examined her. She was examined by some of the sages of the age, including the heads of the church and the state and so on, and she answered every question so well that she left her speechless. But she was also then treated with hostility, because there is something wrong with a woman being that smart. And those people all knew it, and they took it out on her. So she became a nun, chiefly to avoid the world. In order to get away from that kind of hostile reception, she thought, I'll be a nun. I'm expected to live around folks. I'm expected to have no husband, heaven forbid. No cooking, no children, no housework, no anything. I will devote myself to thought and consultant for her abilities, she knows what she's talking about. Sonnet, in which she conveys how it wounds her to be insulted for her abilities. So great, O fortune, has my trespass been, that I must suffer not the punishment of thought alone, but of the malice sent into my ear to wound me with its din. So harshly am I treated, I begin to understand with what unkind intent you deigned to render me intelligent, only to charge me dearly for that sin. Applause you gave, that I might be maligned, exalted me toward greater pain to mine. Dealt with me so perfidiously, I find your ill will doubles what ill luck I borrow. So that, rich in those gifts you gave my mind, I earn nobody's pity for myself.
The event continues in Westchester, Pennsylvania through Friday and Saturday, with workshops for conference participants and poetry readings open to the public. For more information or to see the conference program, visit www.wcupa.edu/poetry.